So today we discussed about the formula in the Power BI, and we have discussed about the nested if formula. Yeah, nested if formula. So the last class we discussed the formula and or formula, right? And or formula. So we have used the if formula depending the and formula, because in the and formula only for the two and or formula get the two conditions, but we have the more condition. So condition is that, so I want to greater than 50 and less than 80. So we don't apply the and formula, we apply the if formula. So click the new new column. And we have give the here, just like it means INC. So if QTY quantity is greater than equal to 50, and give the again if quantity is less than equal to 980, then show the 800, otherwise 0, and also close the again one if and comma 0. So we have used the two ifs, so we have give the two else here, and then the comma by mistake we have give the colon. Now you have get the your result here, but I want to the more and more conditions. So how can, so we have the slab. So I want to calculate according to slab if 0 to 40, then I want to give 500, and 41 to 80 give the 1000, and 81 to 100 give the 2000, and greater than 100 give the 5000. This is the slab. So for that we use the nested if formula, because every number we have the results. So that time we have give the if conditions. If its quantity is less than equal to 40, then 500. Again, if quantity is less than equal to 80, then 1000. Again, if quantity less than equal to 100. So we have below to above, we have give the your conditions below to above, then 2000, otherwise 5000. And no need to close or if, just press the enter, your closing bracket automatically close by your function. Here is a missing sign box. If 500, and if quantity is less than 1000,
you just write the full range. Below 80, right? But you didn't write 40. Above 40.
The below, less than equal to 80, then 1000. Formula is the correct. But why give the error? I think we have not closed your bracket. Hmm. if quantity less than equal to 40,
no, if it is between 41 and 80, right? If you write just below 80,
this is not mistake, this is the mistake. We have give the two brackets. Formula is correct. Okay? Do you understand, sir? How can you do it?
Okay.
So we give the multiple conditions with the if. And how can you use the or? So this is the name. Some people, I want to just give the role and off role. We have the some people that in the on role and some people the off role. So this is the in-house and vendor. So I want to show in-house and vendor. Right, sir? So add the new column. Type the heading, the type. So we have also applied the OR formula here. OR name is equal to Dev, comma. Again, name is equal to Leela. In the inverted comma, Leela. Then this is now option to third condition. So last time we discussed okay, we have used the again OR formula okay, OR, and then we have give the third conditions okay, name equal to Manoj. And you want to have the fourth conditions, again give the OR formula, the starting, and give the another conditions. Name is Amma. Okay, and close the bracket, press that. So if you have the multiple conditions and OR, that time we use this method. We can use the apply or comma or comma or in the or in the or. Last class we discussed about, but we have not used this type of formula. We use the simple if formula here. So if name equal to day, then give results in-house. We have copy this formula, so you have not repeated time enter. Then name not a Dev, we have Manoj, then again if sorry, we have not give the if condition here. Here mistake here. If, then again if, and name is equal to Leela. Leela. And then present. Then at the window. And press the enter. You got the result. But you have the more and more list. This is the smallest list. But maybe you have the multiple list. Then we use the behavior, create the new table. And we use the lookup value, not a lookup value formula. Lookup value formula just like a VLOOKUP. In future classes, we discuss about. So next formula is the choose formula. So first we have opened the list of the logical formula from the website. This is logistical footprint. The switch formula. The switch formula, no need to give any time. Just like example, that formula we have applied this type of the nested formula. We have also give the switch formula here. The switch expression seat name value day result in house comma value to Leela result in house. Three, Amar result in house. So switch formula, with switch formula you have give the value condition, value result, value result, value result. But remember, this formula not accept the logical operator, he accept the exact value, right sir?
Yeah.
So you have used the also it formula. So we have finished the logical formula, the and, if error, not, or, switch, true and false also. We have not cover the if agile formula, because this is the DAX query formula. When we study DAX query, then we discuss it. Now this formula not useful formula. This is not useful. Turn the first section that does not evaluate the blank. If you SL not have blank, then return the two other by false. This is the unnecessary formula. We have not used it. Okay. So please do with the practice on the if condition logical formula, and next class we discuss about the text formula.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So tomorrow Excel class meet on 1 p.m.
Okay.